Yeah. Okay, anyway, these bees are, they're small colonies inside these hives. You can see there's some activity, it looks good, but you can see I have the entrance reduced because there's hardly any bees inside. They're basically, the bees are restricted to that bottom deep in this colony and that colony as well. They're basically new colonies. They're not in any danger of swarming. But these guys, it's a 4-deep colony, fully established colony that's raring to go. They're going at it big time. You can see there's a lot of bees, a fair number of bees anyway, coming and going. It's about 1:30 p.m. right now, and this is a fairly active hive. You can see that there's more activity in the top entrance as well. And anyway, I've got a 1 deep on top and then 3 deeps on the bottom. I'm removing the top deep because they're actually filling it with honey already. They're starting to make honey already. And I want to be able to dig down into the deep, the next deep, to get some brood so that I can take that brood and give it to these guys over here, because these guys are not really that strong. And as soon as I can do that, I plan to put a honey super on top, and they'll take all that energy they seem to have right now into making honey. I wouldn't be surprised if they're already preparing to swarm. There's a lot of bees in there. They're doing really well. And they may be running out of space. And June and July and May are the prime time swarming season. So you never know. They could be swarming. And every swarm I've had, I've had it because I neglected to look, to check regularly during the swarming season to see if they were swarming or preparing to swarm. Because I always thought, oh yeah, no, they're okay. They're not going to swarm. And they always did. So I will be checking on, I will be keeping a close eye on this colony for the next week at least. And here's a cat. Let's see what happens. Hey, Mabel, what's going on? Yeah. Uh-oh, where are you going? Yeah, just hanging out.